great being here. The Old Trafford, new place, new ground for me, this is.
Yeah, I was going to say, it's like all changed here. They've changed the wicket round. Impressions so far?
Very favourable. It looks a stunning place. Obviously, they've matched up the red building. They've upgraded the old pavilion. And they've got this huge, huge stand here with 8,000 people all around. It's impressive. I'm quite pleased with how it looks.
Well, you say a huge stand. If I could take you back to the fourth test, 86-87, man of the match, Gladstone, 5-48 there. 58,000 Australians at the MCG. How exciting was that to play in front of?
58,000 still drunk Australians, though, I think. It was box in there. I mean, listen, it was a great moment in my career. I was ready. I was looking forward to it. I was having a good tour. I was having a good tour of Australia, playing the tour matches, taking wickets. And even though I wasn't in the other lineups, that was the fourth test match of that series. Graham Dilley failed a fitness test that morning, and Mike Gatton, the captain, sort of said, "Right, Stoney, right, mate, you're bowling well. You're in the team." And I remember we won the tour, sent the Aussies in. And Gat, obviously, great top man, Gatton. He obviously had a bit of a sense of humour as well. But he sent me down towards a section of the ground at the MCG place called Bay 13. And I think they let him out from the local asylum just in order to go to the cricket that day. So I remember walking halfway down to this huge place, the MCG. And I got, you know, the bits of hot dogs and chicken legs and apples and oranges and all coming thrown my way. And that was the welcome I got that morning. I was able to take an early wicket and kept them quiet anyway. So it was a great day, you know, good times.
And going into the tour, England were kind of written off by the British media, weren't they?
I think so. I think one of the wags in the media, I think it was Martin Johnson of the writing for the Independent at the time, called us the team of can'ts. Can't bat, can't ball, can't feel. Michael Gatton's team speech. I think that first morning at Brisbane. Here we are, boys. Here's what the press have been think about us back home. Let's go show them that we're not. And we went out that day. I mean, both of them scored a sensational. I think he got 130 odd. Merv Hughes, the big Australian off, was making his debut that match. And Beefy played another great Ashes innings that day, that Brisbane. We got a big score, and then we won that one from nothing. Because we were having the best of tours going up to that one. We were beaten by the Queensland pineapple growers and the New South Wales wine farmers. And so we lost quite a few games leading up to that test match. And it needed someone like Botham to come up and say, "Right, boys, this is surreal now." And he did. He said he would, and he did do it.
So it must have been a quiet Christmas day at the team hotel for the boys then, to come out on Boxing Day and play like that, Gladstone.
When you've got the likes of Botham and Lamb and Gower and these guys in a touring party, there weren't many quiet days, I assure you. And Christmas Day certainly wasn't. Yeah, big fancy dress theme day, breakfast with the press. Good fun there. You have a eat and drink as much as you want, go to sleep early, wake up the next morning. And luckily I didn't go out. I was getting calls from a lot of my friends. I'd played cricket in Melbourne the previous couple of seasons. So I was getting calls from a few of the guys, saying, "Come on, Smalley, come and have a beer with us down the beach, because you're not playing tomorrow anyway. You might as well come and enjoy yourself." And I resisted all that. I resisted all the temptations to do that. Get myself sort of focused that I might be in the team next day. Graham Piccadilly sadly didn't make it, so I got the call up that morning, and I was ready. I was ready to play against Australia for sure.